Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video guys, I'm gonna show you cup sizes 6, 7, 8, 10 and 12. I'm gonna show the amps, the gas flow. We all know the cup size affects the shape and the size of the weld bead, as well as the amount of shielding gas coverage. I'm gonna showcase how each of that cups work, particularly for capping in this video. So I'm gonna show on a 6-inch SCED 40 pipe. I'm gonna do a nice prep. As you can see, nice, clean, shiny. I'm gonna take adjustable square and mark half an inch. Every half an inch, I'm gonna do a mark. I'm gonna put in positioner and gonna grab a wrap around and mark the lines. So once the lines are marked, just gonna grab a grinder, zip cut or 332, and just run your lines on the both side of the line, so you got so you don't lose it. Especially when you're welding, you can burn them out. So cup size 6. The ideal gas flow for cup size 6 is 5 to 10 cubic feet per hour. And the advantage of using a cup size 6 is provided a concentrated shielding gas flow, which is beneficial for precise and detailed welding. So I'm gonna go with 105 amps. And as I said, 5 to 10 gas flow, walking the cup as I'm showing, particularly for capping. As I'm trying to do on cover both sides, as the cup 6 is a small diameter, it's hard to really crank amps too much, as you can't follow. It's really hard to handle, especially on a smaller cup, especially when material gets hot and it's became slippery. I know probably you all, lots of you guys have those problems. When material gets hot, gets contaminated, it's like dirt and oil grease come up on the surface and it's really slippery. You try to walk the cup and just slips. That's it pretty much for the cup size 6. So cup size 7, slightly larger diameter, and the gas flow is from 15 to 20 or 10 to 15. 110 amps for this one. So the same thing. This is 332 filler wire. It's way easier with a smaller cup, smaller diameter cups, when you do capping 6 and 7, for example, to use 332 filler wire. It's gonna, especially on amps like 110, you're not gonna weld big pipe 180 amps or 200 with a cup size 6 or 7. So definitely you have to reduce the amps. Use a smaller rod diameter for in filler wire, and you're gonna have a better control, as your steps when you walk in the cup, it's not gonna be too wide. So the perfect the gas flow amount is gonna have a really good protection over your weld puddle. The colors are the same pretty much. You want to have that consistent step. Try to maintain the straight edge on both sides, and you're gonna notice the difference once we move to higher. For example, now cup size 8, the gas flow between 15 to 20, so let's say around 20, and 130 amps. So with a higher amps and a little bit larger diameter, it's a big difference between 6 and 8, which you can see here. So with the higher amps, the weld pool becomes more liquid. That means we can speed up our travel speed. when the puddle is liquid, you can have a little bit better control, especially if you speed up. As I said, depends on your travel speed and how much amps you can handle. I'm still using 332 for this one. Now it's already easier to cover that half inch wagon tracks I did on the both side of that line. And that's it pretty much. That's what we got usually on a pipe, especially 6 to 8 inches. That's what it is. It's a little bit, maybe half inch, maybe a little bit more for your cap. Same thing, color is the same. Now cup size 10, it's a little bit different story. That's a 2 steps above 8. The gas flow is gonna be from 20 to 25. I'll set it around 25. Now we're gonna go 160 amps, stick out, same thing. Make sure your tungsten is always sharp, that's way easier, helps to you control your puddle, that's for sure. So with a larger cup, as you can notice right here, it's really easy to cover that half inch, let's say bevel in this case, to make your final pass on any pipe. It's way easier with a higher diameter of your cup. With higher amps, the puddle is more liquid, which gives you even better control. And then you're gonna have, as you can see here, nice. You can lay really, really nice, nice welds. Every step, you can see how it looks like. Way easier than manipulating that puddle with a cup size 6 or cup size 7. Of course, the gas flow makes big difference as well. Keeps your weld puddle really nice and clean. And covers 100% that half inch marks. Cup size 12, even bigger difference. The cup size 10, two numbers up. So ideal gas flow, it's 30-35. I'll go around 35. And 180 amps, you can even go 200, but as I said, it's a 6-inch pipe, so it can get really, really hot. You don't want to have that really hot. It works better when the material you're welding on, it's actually not that hot, and that's even better. So which each step covers more area that you can cover for your with your capping, with your pass. This is 1/8 filler wire. I forgot to mention that for cup size 10 and 12, I use 1/8 filler wire. And with a 180 amps, you can see it really melts that rod, and that puddle is liquid. It can be even more liquid, as I said, like 200 amps. You can go, and you got really, really good control over. You can really maintain that straight, consistent steps. That's how you're gonna get nice, good looking bead on both sides. So 12, 10, 8, 7, and cup size 6. And also, of course, you can pay attention to your edges. You can see here on a 12, both sides, and 10 compared to 8, 7, and 6. And it's gonna have a little sawtooth on the side. That's it for today's video, guys. I hope you like it. I hope you're gonna use a little, maybe those settings apply to your work. Don't forget to subscribe, like, click the bell button, and see you in the next one. Take care, guys.